You know, last night on Big Break NFL, after all the infighting and sniping, sometimes between teammates themselves, there was an elimination. A team went home for the very first time. Here's a recap right now of Big Break NFL.
If Stephanie misses, Team Del Greco will be the first team eliminated.
She missed it,
and that's it. That is the end of the road for Team Del Greco. Stephanie Kanoia, Oren Gary, and Al Del Greco eliminated from Big Break NFL.
I knew that our chances were over.
And that's hard for me because I'm a born competitor and I don't like to lose.
It's a hard burden to carry knowing that I let two other people down.
First of all, you didn't let your team down one bit, right? You gave a great effort this week.
Even though we lost, I would not have picked better teammates.
It feels bad to lose, but I'm always going to play this game. I don't care.
If you watched last night, it really was a very emotional hour of television. We've been lucky enough right now to be joined by Stephanie Kanoia and Oren Gary, who were eliminated last night on Big Break NFL. Good morning, guys. How are you doing?
We're doing all right. We're hanging in there. It's tough to keep watching over and over and over again.
Those were real tears. I mean, you guys, you know, it was tough to be the first to go. I'm sure you were at a beautiful spot, first of all, the Dorito Beach Resort in Puerto Rico. But to be the first team to lose, it had to be difficult. You're there among competitors and friends. Oren, what was that like to be the first team voted off the island, as it were?
I'll be honest, I don't remember losing. I think they changed the whole thing.
It's all a blur.
I'm going to sue. I'm just kidding. It's tough, you know. I mean, we thought we had such a great team, and we still think that. And I think if we had to do it all over again and I was given a choice, I would have picked my team. And it was a tough feeling, but like you say, it took me a good few hours to get over it, because I got up in the morning and I was in a 6-star resort. And, you know, we just called each other and said, what do you want to do today? And that was great.
How about your tears, Stephanie? I mean, that was real. You were really upset. You were sad about what you said, letting down Al and Oren.
Yeah, you know, I told myself going into it, oh, I'm not going to be one of those girls who cries. And you get there and you get so attached to your team. You get so attached to the competition. Like I said, I am a born competitor. I want to win everything that I go to. But I think Jerry Rice said it best in a few episodes before. You learn a lot more from your losses than from your wins sometimes. And I can't tell you how much I learned from this experience and have used to further my career just in the last 6 months. And it's been remarkable. So I'll forever be thankful for this experience, win or lose.
And you can take this edge to LPGA Tour qualifying. That is a rigorous road. I've tried it myself a couple of times. Finals, very hard to get through. What are you going to take from your experience at Big Break to help you make it to the next level?
Yeah, just the confidence of knowing that both my teammates were willing to put me in that pressure pack situation at the last minute and have their fate in my hands. And also just the confidence of knowing that I can perform under pressure. I mean, this is some of the most pressure-packed situations that I've ever performed in, and that's exactly what Q School is. It's performing right at that moment when you absolutely have to, when your nose is on the line. And so to be able to take that into that situation is great experience. It's an experience that a lot of those girls there won't have. And I can say, you know what? I have the experience. I know how to do it. I'm going to go do it.
Well, we all know that golf is a journey, and it's a long journey. Oren, what's next for you?
Well, I would say I'm in recovery mode. To be totally honest, the last couple of years I haven't played great golf, and Big Break Indian Wells was a great wake-up call for me. I think I've been doing a better job working on the game and practicing. I thought before this that I was going to be a lot more ready, but Golf Channel throws those curveballs at you, and they want to catch you just a little bit off guard, and they did, and it let me know that I have more work to do. And so I'm continuing sort of rebuilding my game. It's something that I've neglected over the years, and you know, I've just relied on my competitiveness to get me through, and You know, I just turned 40, so I need to get a grip, and I think I'm doing a good job.
Welcome to the club.
I'm in the 40s now. Welcome.
Literally,
welcome.
Right?
Appreciate how candid you are. You know, Golf Channel throws curveballs. Think about how it is working here every day. We're docking curveballs every day, Orrin. But you referenced Jerry Rice and some knowledge that he imparted on you or that you gleaned from him. Mm-hmm. You guys had a chance to partner up with Al Del Greco, who obviously was a legend in his own right in football and also was a really talented golfer. What else did you learn from these NFL legends?
Oh, I'll tell you, I learned more than I ever imagined. When they told us that the NFLers were coming out, I'm thinking, okay, you know, it'll be fun, they'll be goofy and crazy. I learned so much from them.
Like what?
Well, just knowing that when they were in what they did in certain pressure situations and how they overcame some mental difficulties and, you know, learning from Al. I talk to Al once a week and we'll talk about tournaments and what's coming up and he'll help me through. Hey, I was feeling this over that putt. What did you feel when you were kicking for the Super Bowl? And how he kind of overcame those obstacles. And I've learned so much from all of those guys. But really, Al has become a great mentor to both of us.
We're seeing how different football can be from golf, by the way. Golf's treating his team. This is good stuff.
It's drama.
They came out, and I was thinking, football players playing golf, really?
Uh-huh.
And then you spend some time with them, and then you play a little golf with them, and then you get it. Mm. And you're like, this is brilliant. I mean, these guys have been getting pumped up for a living their whole life. They use the adrenaline to their advantage. When they get pumped up, they're going to hit harder. They're going to run faster. They might play through an injury. What do you do in golf? You have to control it. You have to maintain your sensitivity. You have to maintain your feel. You can't really get all riled up.
Right.
How are they going to do it? Well, you know, guess
some
what?
Some did it better than others.
You guys, your personalities are as bright as the clothing that you've been sporting today and also on the show. We've really enjoyed it. We want to keep you around for another segment. We have a little treat coming your way. Dr. Gio Belliante, who is here with us as a special guest on this edition of Morning Drive, he has worked with a couple of Big Break contestants. No one knows better than Gio how tough it is mentally to compete in this show, and he's going to help us understand it on the other side.
All right.
Wow, great.